Greetings, dear ones. I'm Cryon of Magnetic Service. Sometimes the channelings that come with facts and figures, metaphors, stories, and sometimes they don't. Sometimes they come with love and compassion and exposure. This is one of those. This is a continuation, dear ones, of the channeling given this morning. And if some of you are listening to this who are not here and have discovered this channeling, and you can't find the one of this morning, you're looking in the wrong place. They go together, and we're going to continue the channeling. And we're going to talk just briefly about consciousness and the bubble. The bubble, as described this morning, is that which has evolved from the box of belief and becomes a bubble of belief. It becomes a membrane that things can pass through. And we're going to talk about that in a moment. Dear ones, this day has been an exposure of logic. Logic that even a scientist in the room would have to agree is there to some degree, that would beg questions about what consciousness might really be. The scientists have shown that consciousness is energy. It's energy on a playing field of physics, because it actually will affect the magnetic grid of the planet, and also that which is random. And these are provable things, and yet you still don't really know what it is. What if consciousness is something that comes from a place that isn't actually a place at all? It's a dimension that is so unusual and so much belonging to a human that you don't even recognize. Do animals have consciousness? The answer is yes, but it's not yours. Do animals have love? Yes. They're attracted to you, you know. They're attracted to your love. Animals that love see you, and they see the master of love in you. If you've ever noticed, no animal decides to be the master of love with other animals then loving it. They're all about you, because they see in you that which is a consciousness that comes from the stars. Angelic, you might say, that is unique to the human being. Angelic consciousness is consciousness which has a multidimensional aspect that comes from beyond. That's not something that you're going to be able to analyze, dear ones. But when you start defining it, it will then defy any kind of examination, because it keeps going. How far can consciousness go in evolution? You have just begun to have a consciousness that is going to pick up information in your past Akash, apply it to your current life, and give you wisdom. Generation after generation after generation, and you will find humanity at peace. Then you're going to find humanity starting to evolve in other ways that won't make any sense right now, because those ways don't even exist. But eventually, that consciousness which we have shown you is physics may actually be able to control the things around you. Your consciousness will have an effect on the planet. Your consciousness might have an effect on physics itself. Your consciousness may actually be able to put you in a body without cells. This room is filled with those without cells. You ever wonder why the indigenous turn to their ancestors so often? Because they can see them. They can smell them. Because it's energy that is revisited where they are, and it's palpable. And in this room, it's filled with energies that are consciousness that have passed. Consciousness of those you've loved and lost that are here. Why would they be here? What would be the reason that they'd even come to this kind of a place where you sit for a meeting? And I'll tell you, it has to do with the bubble. Dear ones, this morning, we stopped the channel when the bubble occurred that replaced the wall of belief. The bubble becomes an allowance. It actually would have a consciousness, that bubble. If you could ask it, dear bubble, who are you and what are you? It would say, I am a sponge. And I am searching for truth in this bubble. And I'm going to allow my truth to alter itself, my belief to become something else, as through the bubble comes things that I didn't expect. And what is that that's going to come through the bubble? What if right now, coming through your wall or your box or your bubble, is going to be the energies of the past, of the ancestors, of Earth itself, trying to get through to say to you, listen up, listen up, listen up. Something is happening on this planet and you're going to need us. Something is happening on this planet where you can't be alone anymore, where you're going to have the wisdom of mom and dad and brothers and sisters and all of those in your bubble now. You're going to have the consciousness of the Gaia, love, Pachamama, that which is Earth, coming into your bubble in a way that makes you one with everything. One. So as you walk the planet, you feel them all. That's a lot different than a wall of belief, isn't it? But it still will define you, dear ones. Because that bubble that will then accept the love of the Earth, of your higher self, of your ancestors, of your relatives, which still exist, all of that will create a human being that is balanced, not afraid. There's nothing that can pierce that, dear ones. There is no amount of darkness that will ever get through that. Have you heard of the Merkaba? This is something which is 8 meters wide that surrounds you, which is the vehicle of spirituality that you'll walk around in. It's not your bubble. That's your consciousness. Your Merkaba, that's your spiritual vehicle. That's what the higher self lives within. That's the pattern of your DNA. And I'll tell you, it's beginning to generate light like it never has before. There are those who say, crying, I'm afraid of dark things. That's an old bias. How can you be afraid when you hold a torch? Where there is light, there cannot be darkness. And every single one of you have a Merkaba that is starting to glow with a light that chases away darkness. Chases away darkness. And where you walk, darkness will recede. That's the new human. Because you have a bubble that is ready to receive things you don't expect. It's not set in its way. The bubble of belief has a membrane that lets things pass through it that are from an area that you need. More love, more compassion, more wisdom, more understanding. That's what the bubble creates. Allowance of change. And dear ones, I'll tell you something. The old soul is really ready for this. Some of you who sit in the chairs right now, you're really ready for this. That's why perhaps you came. startling, esoterics are beginning to shift this humanity that you live in. And it's why you sit in the chair so you can hear this. There's a tendency of the linear human being to get out of the chair at the end of this meeting and say, well, that was a lovely meeting. And that's it. What are you afraid of? Are you afraid of being loved too much? What are you afraid of? That you would not be able to accept what I'm telling you? That those you've loved and lost are here? Are you afraid of that? That there's so much love for you of the universe that with free choice it's got his hand out saying, there's more here, you know. Every issue in every chair in this room is solvable. Every issue. No matter what you've been told, no matter what you think, dear ones, there is so much here for you. That's with that acceptance bubble that walks out of this room and says, this or something better, bring it on. Because I am done with building walls. I want a bubble where my belief can be enhanced by things that are new and it won't hurt. And I don't have to offend my friends because I receive more love. I don't have to proselytize. I don't have to evangelize. All I have to do is love and walk from place to place in a balanced way. And the children will see it, and the animals will see it, and those around you will see it. Even the plants will know. That's a fact. That's the profundity of what is ahead. That's why you're here. It's not a long message, but it's one I want you to hear. Perhaps you've just tuned into this, and you should hear it again, because it tells you you are magnificent. All of you, born that way with free choice to enhance it, instead of go into a shell that is filled with fear and darkness, as some of you have. It's time to break out of it. This is a good time, for there is coherence right now in this room. There are those who will help if you allow it. And you don't even have to meet them. You help each other simply by sitting in each other's Merkaba. By a coherence that's generated in this place that goes beyond what you ever think would be. Hard to believe, is it not, that there are others in this galaxy who know what you're thinking right now, who are watching this planet, watching coherence, having celebrations because you broke out of the norm and you made it past 2012. That is a truth that someday will be validated. And you'll be here, dear ones, all of you. It may look a little different, but you'll be here. Beautiful, the system that exists, beautiful, filled with purpose and love, compassion, logic, reason, just for you. This is the teaching of Crian, it always will be. Blessed is the human who hears this, cognizes it, understands it, and leaves differently than they came. And so it is.